The plan for the lesson is this. We'll start by defining bipartite graphs, the concept of matchings, and some other needed ideas. Then, we'll show how the problem of finding a maximum matching can be reduced to the problem of finding a maximum flow, and this will give us an E times V algorithm. Next, we'll show that the vertex cover problem is related to the max matching problem much in the same way that the minimum cut problem was related to the max flow problem. And finally, we'll give the Hopcroft-Karp algorithm and show that it finds a maximum matching in time order E times the square root of V. There are many good references on the topic of maximum matchings in bipartite graphs. This lesson will follow most closely Kleinmug and Tardosch's algorithm design for the first three parts, and Dexter Kosin's The Design and Analysis of Algorithms for the Hopcroft-Karp algorithm. We begin our discussion by defining the notion of a bipartite graph. An undirected graph is bipartite if there exists a partition into L and R, think left and right, such that every edge has one vertex in L and one in R. For example, this graph here is bipartite. I can label the green vertices as L and the orange ones as R, and then every edge has one vertex that's green and one that's orange. A few observations are in order. First, saying that a graph is bipartite is equivalent to saying that it's two-colorable, for those of you who are familiar with colorings. Next, let's take the same graph and add this edge here to make it non-bipartite. Note that I've introduced an odd-length cycle, and indeed saying that a graph is bipartite is equivalent to saying that it has no odd-length cycles. For graphs that aren't connected, it's possible that there will be some ambiguity in the partition of the vertices, so sometimes the partition is included in the definition. And we also often draw the graphs with all the vertices in one partition on the left and all the vertices in the other partition on the right.